Today we will discuss what are the arrays. An array is a collection of different variables. I can write on this an array is a collection of variables. That can store data. Of same type. Basically, array is a composite variable, you can say in simple words, or array is such a variable which can work for multiple variables. If we need to store so many values, records or data, so that we can reuse anywhere in the program again, so definitely we need to have the array. Array can work for more than one variables, a collection of variables, but the main restriction is all that values must be of the same data type. Means if we need to store the numbers, then all the elements of the array will be of number types. If we need to store the string, then all the variable or array elements will be of the string data type. So array can work for more than variables. For example, if there is a class of 20 students and they take any test and we need to store the marks of that test, so definitely one way is to make 20 different variables. So 20 different variables will not be a sensible solution. Why? Because we need to write the 20 different set of statements of the input, because every variable will have the different name. If we make use of the loop and give only one variable, then the problem cannot be solved, because every time the loop runs, the value of the variable will be overwritten. That is why there is no other solution. So we just have to give the 20 different statements, input A, input B, input C, input D, 20 different variables. That will be a very hectic task. So in order to rescue ourselves from that, we need to have an array. Array can store all the values and it can sustain all that value so that we can reuse in the program. So before we move towards what is the structure of the array, let me define what the array's types are. Array can be of one dimensional and two dimensional. Our course so far is concerned with the one dimensional arrays, but definitely we do need to have an idea of what are the two dimensional arrays. One dimensional array mean there will be a one dimension. For example, it can be horizontal like this. An array is a collection, mean for example, this is an array, its name is test. We need to store the marks of the test. So if we define a single dimension array, either it can be in horizontal form dimension. I'm making the tables 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is an array. Its name is test and it can store 6 different numbers, 6 different values at 6 different locations. These locations either in horizontal way, or we can restructure it in this vertical way. Again, I'm making the boxes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. I will give the index number to each location 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So one dimensional array mean it can be in one direction, either can be it horizontal direction or horizontal dimension or vertical dimension. It cannot be cannot work with two dimensions at the same time. So in two dimensional arrays, it can have both horizontal and vertical dimension, or you can say row and column. It can be a combination of row and columns. If we just define or design the structure of two-dimensional array, it can be somewhere like this. A table is there, columns and rows. So we can say in double-dimensional arrays, we have two dimensions, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, and row 1, row 2, and row 3. So in two-dimensional arrays, we work with two different dimensions at the same time, horizontal and vertical. So at the moment, we will discuss the single dimensional array. So as we have defined that an array is a collection of variables that can store data of same time, but it can work for many variables. but all that variables must be of the same type. So there is a scenario, and in this scenario we will learn how we can declare the array, how we can use each dimension of the array to store different values. So here is the way. For example, there is a class of 20 students, and they all that students have taken a test, and we need to store the marks of all the students for that test so that we can reuse. So we need to record the 20 different marks of a subject in a single dimensional array. First we need to declare the array. How we can declare an array? As we have talking about dimensions, so that is why we define an array with this term dim. Dim, the word derived from dimension. Now we will tell the name of the array. For example, a class has taken a test, so I am giving an appropriate name to this array, that is the test. It can be a simple variable type, so we can give any name. But now we have to tell for how many variables this test array has to work. So that I will give into this bracket. I'm writing 20 because there are 20 students, and we need to store the marks of 20 students in test. So next I will give the type, which type of data can be stored in all the 20 elements or in all the 20 indexes of this array test. I'm writing its type as integer because mostly marks are stored in whole numbers. So this is how we can declare an array. Dim, name of the array, it can be any name, A, B, C, X, Y, Z, word, two words, and then in bracket we will tell for how many words this array will work. And then we write the type of the array, mean the type of data that will be stored in all different 20 locations of this array. So we have declared this array. Now what happens when we declare this array in memory at the back end? A test, a building block, like for example when we define simple variables like A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, what happens? The OS in memory allocates an area for this variable, gives the name A and store the value 10 in that. Same is the case with B. OS makes allocation in the memory, gives its name to B and store the value 20. Now whenever we are referring these variables, their value will be displayed or value will be updated. For example, when I say print A, the 10 will display. And if I say print A plus 10, so definitely it will print A's value by adding 10 into that, that will be 20. So that is why simply when we define the singular variables, the memory is allocated all that variables, the name is given and data is stored into that, which can be varied, which can be updated during execution of the program. Same is the case with array. When we define an array, we give the command dim, name of the array, for how many variables it will work, and the type of data that is going to be stored in each index or each element of this array. So what happens when we define any array? The OS actually makes a block of memory and gives and makes different allocations or boxes, you can say, or different locations for each element of this array, and writes or gives its number in write sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on up to 20, last will be 20. Now there are different 20 locations have been assigned to this array, and all this is done at the back end, not a part of the question, not a part of the solution. This is just to understand what will be going on at the back end and how the arrays are managed by the operating system. So when we declare this, operating system makes a block of memory or designed this blocks which will have different floors like first, second, third. So these are the different locations which are assigned as it we have given its strength in the variable or array 20. So it will make 20 different locations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, up till 20. Now if we need to write, I'm just need to tell you, this is known as the name of the array, and this is the index. In technical wording, the strength of the variable is known as its index, or sometimes we can say it subscript. So we have defined this array test, and its index is or subscript is 20. It means this array will work for 20 different variables. And what are the strength is in basic language, the location numbers are given right from 1 or always starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in right sequence up till 20. For example, if I make an array test bracket, in bracket I give 30, the locations will be 1 to 30. So locations are given right in the order start from 1. So now how we can write any number into this array? What we will do, for example, I just write test. Now array name only is not enough. Definitely we have to give its index number. I am writing 2 intentionally. Test bracket 2, I am giving 2. Now I write the number, for example, 100. Now where this test of 2 or test variables or arrays, second location or sequence number 2 means the 100 will be stored in second location of the array test. So here it will write at 2 the number 100. If I am writing test and in bracket I give the element sequence or index number is 4, I am not writing any number, that number will definitely go into fourth location of this variable or array test, and it is returned 200. So same is the case of writing, and same is the case of reading. If I am writing print name of the array and I give the number or index number of the array, for example 4 this time, so in this scenario what will happen when we run the program, the computer will display array test location number 4. It means the value that has been stored in fourth location of the test will be displayed, because we have given the name of the array and in bracket we have given the index number 4. So that is why it will display the value 200 on screen. Same is the case if we am writing input, for example input, and I give the name of the array and then I am writing the element number. It is very important, only writing the array name is not enough, definitely we need to give it subscript or index number. So I'm writing input test, now I need to give the index number, I'm giving the index number is 3. Now what happens by this command in basic language, when we run the program a question mark will be there, and when you write any number, for example you are writing 75, this 75 number will be stored into the array test and in third location of the test. So here it will write the 75. So this is how we can store the values in a single dimensional array, or we can write the values in single dimensional arrays different location, and how we can print the values and we can input the values. So in today's lesson we just got an idea what a single dimensional array is, or what an array is overall. An array can be a collection of variables that can store data of same type. It can work for more than variables. For example, we got an example like a class is there which is having 20 students, and all that students take a test. So we need to record the marks of all the students of that test. So we have declared an array dim. Dimension, this is a reserved word, a way to declare the array dim, name of the array, in bracket we will give over how many variables it will work, and then we give the type. When we do this, an array's return is designed at the backend by the OS. It makes a block and there is different rooms in that block, different locations. Every location is given the number starting from 1 up till 20. Now how you can store the write or read the value of any element of this array. So the way is give the name of the array, like I have given the name test, that is the name of the array, and now need to give this index number of that array, that is 2, and I'm writing 100, giving 100. So this 100 will be written into the array's second location. So now I am writing again test index is 4 equal to 200. It means now 200 will be returned into the fourth location of the test. So same is the case, this is how we can record the numbers and this is how we can display. In display we will give the command print name of the array, and in bracket I will give the index number 4. So in this case, it will display the value written at the fourth location. So this is how we can read and write the values. And same is the case with the input. If we demand input from the user in some scenarios, so we give input space name of the array, and in bracket we are writing the index number. So what happens when we run the program and values asked, when you type the number, that number goes into that particular location. So in this lecture we learned what the arrays is, what are its two dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensional means, and what is the actual procedure to declare it, how we can write or access different elements of array, how we can write different number in any element of array, and how we can print the value or the index, any index value given in the test array. And then we learn how we can take the input from user when the program is running by writing input command and giving the name of the array and writing its subscript. So this is how the single dimensional array works.